Hello everyone, I am Tejas Thakur. Welcome to the fifth video of this 12 video series of our module Debt Demystified. This is being brought to you by ProStart, a video-based training initiative by Kotak Mutual Funds. In the earlier video, we learned about Bond Terminologies Part 1, where we discussed yield in bonds, macula duration, etc. In this fifth video, we'll have a look at Bond Terminologies Part 2. Let us look at the first concept which we're going to discuss for today, and that is modified duration. Modified duration is a modified version of the macula duration. Modified duration refers to the change in the value of a security 1% change in the interest rate or the yields. The formula for calculation of modified duration is as given under. So if you see, modified duration is equal to macula duration divided by 1 plus yield divided by the compounding frequency. Let us understand this better with an example. So let's assume that the macula duration is 1.86, the yield is 9%, and the coupons are paid half yearly. The modified duration will be 1.86 divided by 1 plus 9% divided by 2. And your answer will be 1.78. Points to be remembered. So there are certain points which you need to remember. They are as follows. Duration is a measure of the sensitivity of a bond's market price to interest rate, that is yield movements. For a 1% per annum increase in the market interest rate, the corresponding percentage fall in the value of the bond is equal to the duration. Let's take an example. If there's a 15-year bond with a duration of 7 years, a 1% per annum increase in the market interest rate will lead to a fall of 7% in the value of the bond. Duration is the elasticity of a bond's price with respect to the interest rates. It is approximately equal to the percentage change in price for 1% change in the yield. The next terminology which we're going to discuss today is convexity. Calculation of change in price for change in yields based on duration works only for small changes in the yields. This is because the relationship between the bond price and the yield is not strictly linear. If the variation in the yields is large, the relationship is curvilinear. This implies that the reduction in the option-free bond price is less than the change calculated based only on duration for yield increase. Also, an increase in the option free bond price will be more than the change calculated based only on duration for yield decrease. This is measured by a concept called convexity. Convexity is a change in the duration of a bond due to the change in the yield of the bond. It's time to play on the front foot, but cautiously. As we move in the risk return matrix from low to high, the product categories which we see from the left to right are liquid funds, ultra short term debt funds, short duration funds, credit risk, dynamic debt, and medium term funds, and long duration funds. The ultra short term debt funds are more riskier as compared to the liquid funds, but are less riskier as compared to the short duration funds. It's time to notch up our risk appetite, but one at a time. I hope this video has given you a fair idea on the various concepts which we learned. If you have understood the concepts well, then it is time for the quiz time. So welcome back to the quiz time. So self-check questions for you. Question number one, what is modified duration? This was what we discussed in today's session. I hope you remember it. Let's see if your answer is right. Modified duration refers to the change in the value of a security for 1% change in the interest rate or the yields. For a 15-year bond with a duration of 7 years, at 1% increase in the market interest rate, what would it lead to? This was an example which we discussed in today's session. So I hope you remember it. Let's see if your answer is right. Yes, it would lead to a 7% fall in the value of the bond. The last question coming up for you. What is convexity? Only two concepts we studied today, and one of them was convexity. Let's see if your answer is right. Convexity is a change in the duration of a bond due to change in the yield of the bond. This brings us to the end of the discussion about bond terminologies. Thank you so much for listening to me so patiently. In the next video, we'll have a look at yield curves. So see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Goodbye.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.